Happy day students, welcome to San Academy Palikkarai. Today we are going to discuss about chapter 12, electricity part 4. Topics to be covered in this session are heating effect of electric current, application of heating effect and electric power. Heating effect of electric current. So in the case of a conductor, any conductor, after a moment, if the current which is moving continuously in it, what happens? Some effect will produce. Maybe it is a magnetic effect or heating effect, right? So heating effect, it is also we are going to consider the application in the domestic purpose. So now we are going to discuss about detail the heating effect of electric current. When a current passes through a highest resistance wire, the resistant wire becomes warm and produces heat. This is called what? Heating effect of electric current. This phenomenon occurs because electrical energy gets transformed into heat energy when current flows through a wire of some resistance R ohm. Role of resistance in electrical circuit is similar to the role of friction in mechanics. So we will now derive the expression of heat produced when current flows through the wire. For this, consider current I flowing through a resistor R, and let V be the potential across it. It's actually we have to consider in the particular circuit. Let T be the time during which charge Q flows. Now when charge Q moves against the potential difference V, then amount of work is what? Q by Q into V. Then approaching this formula into power, that means that the source must be supply energy equal to V into Q in time. Then power, how we can write? P is equal to V into I or V into Q by T. Okay, so here power is equal to work by time, we have studied in class 9. Now we are going to relate power is equal to VQ by T. Then Q by T is nothing but its current. The energy supplied to the circuit by source in time is P into T, that is VI into T. Okay, that is P is what? VI already we know. So this is the amount of energy dissipated in the resistor as heat energy. Thus for steady current flowing I in the circuit of time, then the heat is produced given by I, H is equal to VI into T. Applying Ohm's law here, above equation, you will get H is equal to I square R into T. So this is what we call this Joule's law of heating. According to Joule's law of heating, heat is produced in a resistor is directly proportional to the square of the current and directly proportional to the resistance of a given resistor and directly proportional to the time for which flows current flows through the resistor. Now we have applications of heating effect of electric current. The heating effect of electric current is utilized in the electric heat heating appliances, for example electric iron, room heaters and water heaters. The heating effect of electric current is utilized in electric bulbs, electric lamps for producing light. An electric fuse is an important application of heating effect of current. The working principle of fuse is based on the heating effect of current. When high current flows through the fuse, then the heat developed in the wire melts and it breaks the circuit. In an electric heater, one type of coil is used. A high resistance material like nichrome or same type of material used as coil. The coil is formed in grooves and ceramic format for china clay. For flowing electric current through the coil, it becomes heated. Due to high resistance, the coil becomes red color forms. Now we have electric power. Electric power is nothing but a rate of doing work or the rate of consumption of energy in the circuit. Now we are considering power is equal to work done by time taken. So the SI unit of power is watt, which is denoted by letter W, capital W. The power of 1 watt is what? The rate of working of 1 joule per second. Actually, watt is a small unit. Therefore, the bigger unit of electric power called kilowatt is used for commercial purposes. So, 1 kilowatt is how much? 1000 watts. So, the rate at which electric work is done or the rate at which the electric energy is consumed is called what? Electric power. And how we are substituting for here the power, we will now derive the formula for calculation of electric power from equation P is equal to W by T, or W is equal to VI into T joules. Now, you know, putting this value in the Wergmann equation, then you will get P is equal to VI, that is what the relation first. Hence, electric power is equal to voltage into current. Why does the card of an electric heater not glow while the heating element does? The heating element of the heater is made up of alloy which has very high resistance. So, when current flows through the circuit element, it becomes hot, too hot and glows red. But the resistance of card, which is usually copper or aluminium, is very low. So, it is does not glow. Compute the heat generated while transferring 96 coulomb of charge in 1 hour through a potential difference. So here we are going to consider charge is equal to how much? 96,000 coulomb. Okay. Time 1 hour we are consuming. So 6 into 16, which is equal to, 16 into 16, we will get 3600 seconds. So potential difference how much? 50 volts they have in the, they have given the question. So I is equal to Q by T, then I is equal to what? 96,000 divided by 3600, that is equal to 80 by 3, that is the answer. That is how much heat generated, or it current produced, the heat generated 4.8 into 10 to the power of 6 joule. An electric ion of resistance of 20 ohm takes a current of 5 ampere. Calculate the heat developed in 30 seconds. So you know very well, the amount of heat produced is given by joules of heating. H is equal to VIT. So current, time, voltage we have. Substitute directly, you will get the value 1.5 into 10 to the power of 4 joule. Hence, the amount of heat developed in the electric ion is 1.4. Thank you.